In this part, we deal with project marketing and sales. Project marketing and sales contains all activities that are carried out before the actual implementation of a project. In large projects, it may take several years from the first contact before actual project implementation starts. I first give you the definition of key terms, what is marketing and sales, and then we can continue with more detailed discussion of the topic. The first part is marketing, which can be defined as systematic management of customer, supplier, and other network relationships related to the development and management of supplier business, and it is designed to achieve the company's desired operational objectives. During this stage, which is independent of any project, the project supplier aims to develop their ability to participate in future projects. But we do not have any specific project in mind. When we discover a customer or a project that we believe will start in some point, that begins the sales stage of the project. Project sales include the activities aimed at making a contract between the supplier and a specific customer. Project sales phase ends with the contract, and after that starts the actual implementation of the project. The marketing and sales of a project is very different compared to ordinary consumer marketing or even industrial marketing. Its special characteristics are strong demand fluctuation, as the customer often will invest only once in large project, and then it may take 10, 15, even 20 years before they make the next large investment. This causes discontinuity in the customer relationship. Projects are also unique. This uniqueness is emphasized especially from customer point of view. To them, it may be the only investment in 10 or 15 years. They are not very familiar with the technology. It's difficult for them to understand which suppliers are able to implement the project. Also, from supplier perspective, each project is at least to a certain extent unique. Even though the project supplier knows the technology as such, it's possible that the market and the customer processes are different compared to previous projects. For example, let's take the delivery of a power plant in Finland. If you deliver it to Africa, these projects are very different from the supplier point of view. Then the last feature is the complexity of the project. And that of course stems from the fact that the project itself is technically very complex and requires many kind of different kind of expertise. From this perspective of sales and marketing, the complexity shows up in the fact that we need many different experts and decision makers in the process. Managing and understanding all these people is actually very challenging sales project. Let's move on to the marketing stage, where creating project opportunity is the key thing. Our starting point is always the strategy and strategic goals of the company. Which markets we want to be in, which products we want to sell. These decisions are not independently made in the marketing and sales unit, but the marketing strategy must take the general business strategy of the company into account. Project marketing activities can be divided into two interrelated set of activities. The first is to develop the product and solution for the market. This includes getting understanding what is required in the market, what are our competitors offering, what kind of possibilities there would be to create new products and services for the market. But project marketing is not only about having the best technical product. We also have to build close relationship with key players, potential partners and subcontractors, decision makers in the business segment, and of course with the customer and their key decision makers. One of the main objectives for relationship development is to become a creditable supplier that will be given an opportunity to participate in competitive bidding process for new projects. By having these relationships, project supplier also improves their technical capability to deliver projects. The marketing stage of the project is considered to end when we recognize the possibility of a project. So from this onwards, our marketing and sales activities are targeted at specific customer. If we have done well our marketing work, we will get to participate in the competitive bidding process, and we will get an opportunity to make an offer. If we decide to continue and participate competitive bidding process, then we have to create a proposal with our partners. And now those good relationships with subcontractors become very important. After this, the customer will usually choose 1, 2, 3 suppliers for further negotiations, and in the end, one supplier is selected and will sign the contract, after which begins the implementation of the project. Of course, the contract is only a starting point for the implementation of a project, and there will be changes that also have to be included in the contract during the implementation phase. From this perspective, project sales continues during the project implementation process, and we have the final contract after project approval and handover to the customer. After the handover, there's support for the use of project product by offering different type of services and spare parts. During this phase, we also aim to maintain close customer relationship and stay close to customer until they decide to make the next investment. From the customer point of view, project activities start from identifying an opportunity. For example, a customer having a pulp mill has realized that their process doesn't function as it should, and that may be possible to improve it by investing to a new automation system. Of course, suppliers have been very active, and as a part of their marketing effort, they have provided information to justify the investment and also how their specific solution could improve customer processes. This stage ends with investment decision. After that, customer prepares technical specification and opens competitive bidding process. There are actually several different options for organizing competitive bidding process, which we will discuss later in more detail. After this, there's analysis and comparison of proposals, and then customer continues to negotiations and contract preparation phase. They usually continue with several suppliers to maintain competition until the contract is signed with one supplier. At the delivery stage, there is the supervision of the delivery, and usually customer also has some responsibilities in the project implementation work. Customer also have to accept any changes that are made during the project implementation. After commissioning of the product and approval of the delivery, customer will start using the project product, maybe using support services provided by the supplier.